So okay, this is like the Christmas village here, and I can't actually make this video tonight because I don't want to disturb the house energy. So I'm right here looking at I don't know. It is a village of all kinds of little buildings, and there's a Santa Claus even here. Santa Claus with his not so bright and reindeers. And so it's actually quite fun, and we have also the lights that sprinkle through the village. And just yesterday I repaired the very important with the glue. It was a very important piece here, the menagerie of the merry-go-round, and it was broken. So now it is fixed, and we have the what do we call them? They are the beautiful little horses there. So the beautiful horses, and they are all upright again. So this was a problem. So a village with a broken merry-go-round. It's like life, you know. We have real villages on the outside, and their merry-go-rounds break, and so we have to repair all these things. So it was actually, it's not then the moment of thinking the thought, it is now. So we have to always repair our villages. Oh my gosh. Yeah, we have fishing supplies there, we have a blacksmith, and we have, what the heck, a fishing supply? So what does it say about the person when they want the fishing supplies? I don't know. See, my choice, I would never have chosen the fishing supply shop. You know, I, that's not me. I would have chosen something else. But that's, you know, it's a taste thing. I've been to the fishing supply villages, like in, where is it? In the north of, Washington there. We have a lot of fishing villages in Olympia State Park, and so there it goes. There's the, my gosh, I hope you all are enjoying Nutcracker. We're starting season soon in Ribelli Berantara. Nutcracker, yes, we have to get back in, and remember we have to do Russian everything, and get ready for the chutzpah of it, because my gosh, how fun. Don't feel, oh my gosh, I probably made funny noise with my shoes. But yeah, no, but we love the Nutcracker and and all of this, don't we? Sorry, I'm getting happy for them, all of the sugar plum fairies. But yeah, the little village, so what was I was trying to say? The little village is, I don't know. I just, that's my only complaint with this village, is there is the fishing supply hut, and I don't know. I don't like them. I don't like all of those, what do you call them? They're those things that you put on there, the hooks. Put the hooks on and then the bait. And I'm not really liking fishing increasing that fishing business. Let's have overfish in the seas and the waters. Well, not less. We don't have to be so hungry for them. I think we have definitely just don't need that as a retirement option either. There's a lot of that going on in France. Every man grabs his tackle box, and that becomes like his new deal in life. Just get him out of the house, make him go fish or something. But I don't know. I just prefer another way to get him out of the house, do something else. Doesn't have to be the fishing. And I don't know, it would be funner if we, oh my gosh, we have so many fish. That would be a funner thing to say, wouldn't it? So yeah, darn for some of these little village items are stupid. And in a way, even the merry-go-round, it got ruined by the Dirty Harry movie. And I'm not really sure I can handle the merry-go-round actually, like in real life, because of that moment, you know, with the, that's a huge weapon. What was it? It was something, I don't know, 45 or something. But yeah, that kind of ruined merry-go-rounds. And then they have all these perverts. And that ruins merry-go-rounds also. So this cute little village that was before, like Rockwellian, is no fun. It's no fun anymore because, one, it renders a fish out and then reminds us of the echo instability. And then I have the perverts of the merry-go-round with Dirty Harry. So it's not actually that relaxing. So it's not relaxing a little village to have in the house. It's quite stressful. And but in all realities, I'll survive it. I will survive it. And I'm actually not gonna be looking and peeking at any others. Well, there was the blacksmith shop. Even that I have to relegate again. Oh my gosh, now there's that name, blacksmith, and well, that's an odd name in itself. Were the smiths, you know, going back to history, do I have to think about this, or were those the black ones, you know, the blacksmiths, and so we called them black smiths. No, it wasn't that at all, but that type of thing happens in people's minds, you know. So as we have the African Americans probably, you know, in their heads going, what, blacksmith, you know, that would be, you know, you're calling me a black man, or and my name is Smith. You know, so, but it actually, it wasn't that, it's an older name. So, yeah, it's odd, huh, it's odd. So you have all of these things. So that might be, you know, hurtful to someone, the name blacksmith. So I have to think about that. It's not politically stably correct and all of it. So even that has a journey into the mind that is, it's uncomfortable. It's an uncomfortable place. And all that banging, clanging, with the anvil, and bending metal and forging it and heating it up, and then we have to think about deforestation. Is that going on in this little village just because somebody needs to shoe their horses? So yeah, a lot of things are happening even in this time state. What else have I got in my? It's pink. I know, and it's actually blue, but it turned pink in the lights. So what is the deal? We have an inn. We have an inn. Well, I guess so. I guess an inn is okay. Yeah, I think so. Can we say inn? Inn is okay? Yeah, we have inns, and then we have what else? We have bed and breakfasts. Those are more, what do we call them? Current. Yeah, so in a way the word inn is kind of like, I don't know, it kind of reminds me of like the Hampton Inn or something. It's just not, you know, as current as bed and breakfasts. Yeah. So, I don't know, it's public, it's a public place, it's extremely public, but it's an inn, so it's kind of like a town that is, it's almost got too many visitors, so what can I say about that? Yeah, so all in all, it would be fun to switch them, you know, switch them for other ones, switch them for other village items, like take that one, that says the blacksmith and turn it into something else from somebody else's house, you know, and we squeeze it. So if you really want the blacksmith, you can have it, you know. So we can upgrade the village, but yeah, I'm not happy with it, actually. Now that I've read the letters and the words of which each house represents. So, but it is funny that it is there. I don't know, this is a little Christmas weirdo, vlog, Christmas weirdo. And then we're having what else? Oh, there's so much going on in this house. My battery is running low on the computer. And yeah, I've got Christmas trees here. I'm just like, I'm in the Christmas, like you can't believe house. There's fairies in this house all over the place. I've got Christmas fairies. So it's raining Christmas time. And it's not going away. But 111, we'll go here. We'll represent him. And he is... Now, this is a QVC channel all of a sudden. Now I'm here going, what the heck is this? This is some kind of a happy snowman dude that, he's called Santa, I believe so. They call him, he has a special name. Normally, formally, yeah, gosh dang. Yeah, look at that cutesy beard. So what is he holding here? It's like a toboggan. He has some kind of a toboggan. And then over there, he has this little ruffle on the bottom of his coat, and that keeps him extra warm. But he's not a fairy. He's not a fairy at all. He's just simply Kris Kringle type. So yeah, see eye to eye with Kris Kringle. Do you really want to look that close at him? And now I'll give you the stare down. Don't forget to shop for Christmas presents for everyone, and Hanukkah also. So there you go, yeah. What a fellow. Not really my type, actually. Not really my type. But sourdough, he's a sourdough, obvious. And maybe bathes once a year. Yeah.